Hey guys, I will be showing you today how to get this style, and I'll be doing it in two different ways. Products you might need are a hairspray, dry shampoo, texturizing spray, clip, a comb, and some bobby pins. So I'm just starting out by using the dry shampoo and spraying it directly on my roots. It's just going to give my hair a little bit more body and lift. And then I'm just going to work that in with my fingers and a comb. Okay, so to start off with, you just want to section your hair down the middle of the back of your head and then comb each section around the front. This part is optional, but if you have a fringe or if you have shapings around your face, it's really cute if you leave it out, and it's just sort of goes with the style. So as you can see, I've just done a regular braid down that side of that section, and it's really important to braid it in as close as you can to the back of your ear. And then I've just secured it with a hair tie and repeating the same steps on the other side. So once you've got both sides finished, you should be looking a little like Pippi Longstockings. And then you just want to take your texturizing spray and spray it onto those braids. And then, as you can see here, I'm just pulling out this each sides of the braid and working my way down. This is just going to make the braid look a lot fuller and a little bit more textured. So just be really careful, especially if you've got lots of layers, because they're probably going to all pop out. But hey, I think that kind of adds to the messy textured look. So once you're happy with how your braids look, you then just want to take one side and flip it right on over and position it into place where you would like it to sit. And then you want to take your bobby pin and just pin it up and underneath the hair tie and put in a couple until it feels really secure. And you want to do the same with your other braid and just position that into place where you'd like it to go, and do the same with the bobby pin. Now, unless you like looking like you've got horns, then you can skip this step, but I'm just going to take a couple of bobby pins and pin down those hairs that are sticking up, which you probably will get. So once that's all up and looking lovely, you then just want to fluff with it, pull some bits out. I've just added some more spray to just to calm down those little fluffy bits, and I've tucked it behind my ears. And yeah, I love this look because you can either have it really neat and tidy or quite messy and textured. Yeah, so that is the first look complete. I'm now going to show you another way of doing this hairstyle, which is a lot more suited to shorter hair. Like if you have hair above your shoulders, then you can still achieve this look. So I'm pretty much, as you can see, I'm starting out doing the exact same steps as the first look. So this is where this look is different. If you know how to do a French braid, you should be able to nail this look. Only different thing that I'm doing is it's a inside out French braid, so instead of taking the strands over one another, I'm taking them underneath. Sorry guys, it's a little bit hard to see as my hair is really dark, but it should be a lot easier to see once I make my way down the hair. So once you've got those braids all done, you then just want to take one side and bring it up and around and clip it with your bobby pin. And then you just want to bring the other side around and secure it on the same side as your other braid. So as you can see, I'm doing the same technique as before. I'm taking the spine of the braid and I'm just pulling each little bit out just to give it a little bit more body. This is great for fine hair because it'll look like you've got, make you look like you've got a lot more hair than you do. I'm just doing it because I really like the look of it to be a little bit more messy. And I have taken the ends of the braids and I've tucked them up and underneath the braid that's next to it and just secured it with a bobby pin. So once you're happy with it and have finished tweaking it, give it a little bit of spray, you should be left with something that looks a little like this. And that's the completed look. I really hope you enjoyed this, guys, and learned something. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.